Through the centuries, Christians have learned to view heaven in different ways. First, heaven has often been depicted as an actual place, the place where believers go when they die. Some people believe that heaven will resemble the Garden of Eden restored to its original state. Other Christians take literally the description of heaven from the last chapters of Revelation, in which the city of the New Jerusalem is portrayed as a place with 12 gates, adorned with jewels, and lit by the glory of God. Sometimes, when we think of heaven, we think mostly in terms of what will not be there. No crying, no sadness, no pain, no sin and no evil, no disappointment, no Yankees fans. In other words, a paradise. A third way to imagine heaven is love. Perfect, pure, simple love. If God is love and His goal for us is love, then heaven must be where that love is made perfect and real. Heaven can also be thought of as a spiritual state. It is something that you can have here and now when you walk in the will of God. In one of his sermons, John Wesley asked his listeners, "Do you have heaven in your heart?" He claimed that heaven takes up residence within our souls when we walk in holiness and happiness. And in one of his hymns, Charles Wesley wrote, "Happy the souls to Jesus joined and saved by grace alone, walking in all his ways they find their heaven on earth begun." You might also think of heaven simply as the presence of God. Heaven is where God is fully revealed and known and is close to us. John Wesley's last words, recorded as he lay on his deathbed, were, "The best of all is, God is with us."